Good evening, sir.
Evening, guys. Antoinette, have you met with your, have you had any other meetings with the, with your artist? Anything from that side? Alternate may have stepped away. Romaria, have you met with your artist, or have you had any subsequent meeting or meetings with the up and coming artists with whom you're working? Is it that everybody disappeared? Not hearing any responses.
Good evening, sir.
Hi, good evening.
I wasn't here on which day you had class, sir. I wasn't here on Tuesday. But I'm having a big problem, sir. Very, very big problem. I am assigned in the group Ocean. That person, sir.
Mm-hmm.
Stephen Paul was a part of the group. And he had texted me and he said that, how may enter into the group without asking the group permission? We kind of settled all of what was going on. That was settled. But thereafter, Stephen Paul is no longer a part of the class. But I have not yet made contact with any of the group members. I have reached out to Stephen to ask them to add me to the WhatsApp group so I can know what is going on. If they had meet with Oshi, what is my part to be done? And presently, sir, I am not getting any response, any way forward. Stephen was the only person who was communicating with me. And apparently, it seems like he had dropped the course. So I am now right here, so mid-semester is coming up and I don't know what is happening.
All right, so we'll address it when more students are in the class, okay?
Yes, sir.
Can you screenshot me or privately text me the names of the group? This is the OSCE group?
OSCE group, yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, I think some of them dropped the course. I don't know what was the issue with them. So if anything, I'll reassign it to another group, okay?
It looked like all of them dropped it, sir, because nobody, I reach out and I'm not getting any way forward from anybody.
I'm put you in another group. Mid-semester, you have to look at the calendar of events. That's usually, just rely on what the college sends you. Whenever they say that I have to administer the mid-semester, that's when I'm going to. I think it's week 6 or week 7.
Okay, so this course has a final exam to it?
Are you in possession of the course outline?
No, sir.
Did you go onto Canvas?
Yes, sir.
The course outline is on Canvas. I'm certain of it because Dr. B put it on it. Let me double check, but I'm almost sure the course outline is there. Very, very sure. So you need to visit, use the platforms. Let me just double check, but I'm almost sure because I did check even last night when I was doing some other things, but I'm almost sure it is there.
So you're a foreigner, sir. You answer like a foreigner, sir.
Why is a foreigner? What do you mean?
Somebody who not live in a Jamaica, sir. And I have to be one Jamaican would have just tell me the answer already, sir.
No, I'm trying to be very professional in my approach, and the fact that you have to take some amount of responsibility in terms of accessing the information. So if you can't rely on me to give you everything. So the course outline is actually on the is actually on Canvas. Let me make sure it's the right version that they actually put up. Is the starter version? This is not the right version. Yes, this is the right version. So the course outline is actually, so let me share a screen and show you that the course outline is there. All right. So you need to use the platforms that are, let me just make sure I don't have anything that is open, that is private or confidential. Okay, let's share a screen. Okay, and this is Canvas. No, that's not Canvas. Didn't I just open Canvas? Are you seeing my screen? Ruth, are you seeing
my
screen? So when you go to home, when you go on the course and you go to home, you go on the model on modules and you see the course public relations here, and this is the course outline. All right, so it tells you in relation to exams. The exam is a practical exam, which means that everybody will be, as a class collectively, be hosting a musical event because you're working with a performer or with an artist.
Okay.
Okay, so if they have dropped the course, and I think I got an email to that effect, no problem. I'm not going to try to debate or, you know, whatever the issues are. I know too that you can't drop a course some at a certain point in a semester. So I hope they don't think that they can come back and say, oh, so we didn't know. Because that's another issue that students don't know, that after a period of time, you're prevented from dropping a course. So I'm not sure if they were in that window. What I will do, if anything, Ruth, is to put you in another group, okay?
So, okay, yes, sir. Well, however it goes, sir. Or if other person can come over, no problem.
No, the other persons are already in their groups. They're not going to come over. They have actually been reaching out to the artists and they're doing work already. So they're not going to come over. It's more you joining them than them joining you.
Okay. No okay. problem.
Yeah, and it's not an issue for me, you know. As I said, it's a collective effort. So the mid-semester is going to be based on what we have been covering in the class. And some of it has to be done. Some of what you'll be testing on is things that you should be reading as well, because you should be following the scheduled reading. The material is also on Canvas. So I'm not going to teach every single thing in a 10. It's a 13-week course being taught in 10 weeks. Things you have to kind of do due diligence in terms of doing some additional work on your own.
Yes, sir. However, on Canvas, sir. Mm-hmm. What I realize, what I see, to which I have printed it, it is a 4-page information that I have already gone through that Wapikil fill a long, long time ago, and that is all that is there. So when you had asked a question the last class that we were in, I had also reached out to a group member to ask them, what is that and how do they go about doing that? Because I don't have no information to guide me as to how do I obtain this information. You had given us a work thing to do in the class to get some information, and I don't have that information as to how do I do that. I'm not seeing the notes. It's just one thing that I'm seeing on Canvas.
Yeah, but I send you emails. Don't you get the emails when I send them?
I have to give you my email, sir. I don't get any email from you.
Yeah, but I've been sending emails to the class. So how is it that you're not getting the emails?
The class, sir.
I'm listening.
The class public relation group, sir, you have been sending emails.
I've been sending emails to the individual students who are in the class because they give me a class list. So I can copy and paste your email addresses, and I've been sending emails to that. I send a few emails to that, and I've also posted the lecture notes. Have you been watching the recordings? We also have you been watching the recordings as well? I'm not sure, probably her connectivity is low. Yeah, probably somebody connectivity is low. I don't know when to start because it's now 5:20 something and many students are not here. So, and I know this, when at 5 o'clock classes are always the worst because students are still trying to get home and sometimes they're in traffic, so they're on and they're off because the signal is dropping or stuff like that. Anybody knew the young man who was the photographer who was murdered? Does anybody know him?
Who? You're talking about Ryan Reed?
No? I said murdered. Ryan was not murdered.
Oh.
Ryan died in the hospital. I'm talking the photographer, Dominic Davis.
The one that takes the ECC photograph?
No, the one, there's a big murder in Jamaica. You don't watch news, Ruth, where do you live? I live in Canada, I know what's happening in Jamaica. I live in Jamaica, I don't know what's happening in Jamaica. And this is something that is trending on social media.
Are the overseas people, them know everything we are going, and we who they don't know nothing, sir.
But it was it's trending on every platform, Star, Gleaner, Observer, CVMT, because I watch TVJ news here because I get a special box so I can get the news in Jamaica. So you don't watch news?
A rural country, minister. Certain things we don't get access to. We live in a deep rural.
Well, I'm not saying that you must know him, but I'm saying you didn't hear about them. He's actually a past student of Exed.
Oh.
And again, I'm reading something about, Jamaica is a very strange place. That's all I say. Killing people. It's very unfortunate. really, really unfortunate. All right, so persons are trickling in. Persons are trickling in. I need to speak back to Dr. B about Canvas because let's do. Because by right, they're supposed to coursework. They're supposed to provide that. Let's choose a file. Yeah, it's not personal actually. It's not even desktop. It is sharing. ACC qualifications. Where did I save it? General? No, this is it. I don't know why they have. Tony, any have you guys been meeting with your with the artists, with the up and coming artists?
Good morning, sir. Yes, we have. We're supposed to schedule a physical meeting with him, but he has not gotten back to me.
Okay, and who's the artist again?
It's on the road. D Chrome.
Okay. All right, so I've just uploaded the, let me just share screen and show you, the assessment document to, so here it is, coursework and practical exam, but I can just share screen until the other persons are here. So you're seeing my screen? Oh, you know what I missed? My God, how could I have missed it? Mid-semester, which is going to be here. How could I forget mid-semester, my Lord? You know what? The mid-semester actually does not need to be. I know what I can do for mid-semester. It actually does not need to be an actual exam.
Sir, I have a question.
Mm-hmm. Go ahead.
All right. So, my group members and I, after reaching out to several radio platforms,
mm-hmm.
they have Zip has contacted us back.
Mm-hmm.
However, the pricing is very high, so we wanted to know how.
But they're not really. They're not supposed to charge you for that. Zip is
our price is ridiculously high. So in the event, because we're working on the viral video,
mm-hmm.
we requested a few tracks from the artists. Mm-hmm. So in the event, if the video does not go viral for possibly radio stations to reach out to him and then he gets an interview, how would we go about doing an interview?
Well, I would suggest that you use probably because like Roots FM, they are cheap. They usually know of anybody anyway. So they probably could put him on. There are some of them that would put him on for free because they really don't have any content. And people don't really, the big artists don't really go there because, you know, the radio station itself is struggling. I understand that it would make sense for you to reach out to like a Zip FM, but Zip, of course, is expensive. I'll contact Monique. I think her name is Monique. I used to teach her at Excelsior. She's there now. Let me just check Facebook if just to and see if I can squeeze a favor out of her since she's used to give me so much talking when I used to teach her. Let me see, Monique. Yes, here she is. But I think she called herself now Zip. My Zip or something like that. All right. Let me see if I can use that. Hi, Monique. Give me a call at. Okay. need to talk to you. Oh, she's actually responding. Yeah, that's good. Can you send me a WhatsApp message? Better to talk on the phone. Because they actually did something for me, and it was entertainment management. So see if you can find some lower hanging fruit, because for the event I've actually been on this behind the scene. I've been trying to get a venue for you guys and trying to see how much I can squeeze some favors out of my. I have a good friend. He has a kind of studio, but he works with a live band and everything. So I was talking to him today, and I said to him, try to see that the cost is not too much, because what I'm going to recommend to you guys, of course, you can find other ways, but you have to
see. There'll be a class effort, right?
Yeah, of course, class effort, definitely. So it will be collective. So if there's a cost, the cost will be shared among everybody. But what I usually recommend to students is that you kind of seek sponsorship. So you create a local sponsorship form, and you say to them, okay, we're doing a public relations course, and this is for this and this and that, and then we just need some funding to stage the event. Because what he's going to actually do is to give you a live band, an actual live band. You're going to get lighting and all of that. And he's one holy power. So he's actually supposed to send me something. So I'm sure it's going to be in about $40,000 or $50,000. So you just spread it across the class. Because most of you guys can beg at work or seek sponsorship at work and get the funding. And just, so in other words, one event, everybody comes and perform. You don't have to have physical people there. You just need people just to tune in, to just stream in. Yeah, you don't need an event where you need a crowd. And no, none of that. Because they have the way that studio, the space is designed. Oh, yes, he's supposed to send me some example. Let me call him.
Okay.
The way the space is designed. Yeah, it's very easy to do it that way. And I've actually been there in the studio because I used to do singing myself, you know. I kind of used to try to perform and all of that. But I've given it up, you know. I'm getting old. And I have to seek other ways.
Roots FM. You know, yes, any other radio station?
So like Roots FM. All of the ones that would have met. No, the one over Portmore, Sun City. Although Sun City kind of have little attraction.
No, sir, Sun City.
Sun City. Some of them I used to work with them. You can find out some programs that even though if the station is good, the program is boring or the program doesn't have a lot of traction, they will kind of put people on. So the artist might go on to talk about his music, but also talk about family life. You kind of find a way to kind of mix it together. Like a Talk Up Youth. Like, for example, a Talk Up Youth. You could probably get one of them on to Talk Up Youth because the person might be going. So one of the artists, and I shouldn't disclose this, but one of the artists, they have a family member, very close family member that suffers from mental illness, serious mental illness. And I've always been saying to him that you need to, that is something that you need to talk a little bit more in your music, because it can actually reach out to the, you know, Mental Health Jamaica. I think there's something called the Mental Health Society of Jamaica or something like that. I said to him that you could actually become their ambassador. But for the mere fact that you have a very, very, very close family member who's suffering from mental health. So there are different ways of how you can kind of pitch. But the artists themselves, you see, until they become very comfortable, they're not going to give you as much information. They have to feel very secure to know that the information is not going to be repeated and that you're, you know, strict confidence and stuff like that. Let me call Matthew. Yeah. Because Matthew's supposed to actually send me some stuff for me to see the reel. He's on another call. I'm sure he'll call me back.
Okay, sir. So we'll contact Roots tomorrow.
Yeah, try Roots. Try some of those online YouTube people who are seeking popularity.
Sir, we have also, and they come at a cost as well. I never know that they're charged. Several of them. Some have reached out, some have not reached out. We're trying every possible platform right now.
Okay. Oh, you know, you can try as well on UE. What's UE? UE has I can't remember the name of it. Because what is the name again? I would have to go. Let me check my ECC email. When I was in marketing, they just sent. That's okay. From UE radio station. What's the call again? Let me Google. I can't remember the name of. Because I know they, for example, sometimes they don't have any UE Mona owner. Have you guys tried radio station? Have you tried people outside of Jamaica, like the YouTube people? Have you tried anybody like that?
No.
New Stock 93 FM. Have you tried New Stock 93 FM?
No, sir. Let me write that one.
Yeah, try New Stock 93 FM. And this is for everybody, and everybody can try. Anybody reach out to Kerry Ann Clark?
Sure, I did, but I did the one wasn't getting through to her. I'm going to try calling back.
All right, let me see if I can text her and ask her. Let me text her right now and see if I can get something out of her. Kerry Ann Clark. Which number is she using now? Oh, is she? All right, so we're just waiting for when two more students come, we'll just begin. All right, so persons are slowly trickling in. All right, Romari, you're saying that there's some information you can share. Go ahead. All right, I'm not getting her. She probably will call me back. That's scary. Have you guys tried the public relations officer, Excelsior's public relations officer? He actually used to work at the Gleaner. You might can squeeze something out of him.
No, sir, we haven't.
So contact the OMMC, the Office of Marketing, Media, and Communication. You guys know. Oh, Matthew's calling back. Hold, give me one sec.
Okay.
Give me one sec, guys. I'm talking to Matthew. Okay, so just give me one sec. All right. Sorry, guys. I was just kind of negotiating a whole bunch of stuff with Matty a while ago in terms of the production. Are you guys seeing me clearly, or do I need to? I have another light that I can turn on for you to see me even clearer.
I'm seeing you, sir.
You're seeing me. Okay. You don't want to see me in the new, in any extra lighting. Okay. All right.
No, sorry, not that.
I'm just rubbing you. All right. So let me share. So let me share what the space looks like, Matthew, because we spoke at length. So it is called PHE Studio JA. This is a space. And when you go, did I turn on my, hold on. I don't think I turned on my, I didn't turn on sound so that you can actually hear what's happening. So this is the space. But and I'm just going to skip through some of it so quickly.
Ladies, did you enjoy that one?
No, that's it. That's the, so remember, no, you need a flyer like this because that comes under promotion, right? Something, you know, I used to teach this young man from Ford Farm, Dominic. His name is actually Dominic as well. This is a space. I've been to the actual space myself because, as I say, it's a good friend of mine. So this is a space again. So this is the space. All right, so the other thing he's saying is that there are a few options, right? You can do, for example, you can make the artist use their tracks, or if you want a small band, a three-piece band with just a drummer, a bass, and a guitar, or you can ask the artist to use their tracks. So that's something that I said to him that I'm going to give, I just want only two persons from the class to be in touch with him, with Matthew. And then he also mentioned whether or not you want the thing to be pre-recorded or you want it to be live. So that again, I said to him, I don't want to make that decision. I want you guys to make that decision because that is part of the practical component of it. To kind of make these kind of decisions as it relates to everything. We're aiming for August 13, which is a Saturday. Is that day good for you guys? A Saturday is good. I know most of you work, or if not all of you work. That's why we aim for weekend.
Saturdays are good for me, sir.
Yeah, it's more a Saturday. And as I said, everybody does not need to be at the event on the day itself because the studio itself is small. You can organize everything and probably just the group leaders on the day, you know, just ensure everything is okay. Usually, and if you do the check the day before, probably just one or two persons can go there on the day. So don't think that everybody needs to go there on August 13 because there's not enough space for that.
Yeah.
Mute your mic, Ruth. I'm hearing everything that he's saying. So how does it sound so far? Does it sound workable?
Yes, sir. For me, it sounds good for me.
Yes. Anybody else wants to, Donovan, anybody else wants to give some comments or feedback in terms of what are your thoughts? Can work, yes?
I'm just joining.
Oh, okay. You were not here before. Alternate, anything from you? I know, I think Lorian was here. Yes, go ahead.
So the interviews would have to be done before that event.
Yes, the interviews would have to be done before because they, in other words, the event itself is the last thing of everything.
Okay.
That's the last thing. And I think actually the 13th is, I think that's the last day of summer school. Actually, that's the last week of summer school. I'm almost sure it's the last week of summer school. And as I say, I've been to this space. I love the space because what happens, because the room is soundproof, the quality of the sound is very, very, very good. They know exactly what they're doing. It's a very good production. And as I said before, in terms of the cost, all you need to do is just get sponsorship and spread the cost across. So everybody, you know, kind of get a little, create a sponsorship form, which is what my students have done in the past, and get some sponsorship from like coworkers, stuff like that. Anybody sees you and likes you, say, okay, I need a donation. I'm just joking. Yes, so yes, you could speak to the artist and see if they rather live bands, right? But remember, live band means more money, okay? Just telling you. Or if they want to use their track. But I think I prefer a live band, to be honest. It's just that with a live band, they would have to go in and actually do rehearsal. Let me see if I can actually find an example. Which course was I teaching? And I actually have an example, because at the time we did it at Excelsior. Hold on, does Excelsior have a band? What about the School of Performing Arts? This could actually be a collaboration with the School of Performing Arts, you know, although they are very, well, let me not say anything, this thing is being recorded. Okay. Hold on, I think I can actually show you an example of something that I did with the students. 1 year. Would it be in photo? I think so. Just need to make sure. It could be way, 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 way down. Let me see if I can download. I think it's... Why did I share it on Facebook? This is a rehearsal. Today we're going to look at press release. So, but I just want to ensure that we get this part out of the way in terms of the... In terms of the practical exam itself, I know I saw it sometime the other day. What was I doing? And I came across the video, and it was actually the rehearsal. Ruth, why are you always unmuting your mic when I mute your mic and you have a very noisy background? Let me just find it. It was a nice rehearsal. If I can find the video, actually. I'm just seeing when I was on radio. All right, while I'm looking for that, any questions? Anybody has any concerns? Anything that you think? I think it's feasible. I think it's possible. Was it this? No, it wasn't this. This was when Jeff was rehearsing. I remember that for sure. But I know I saw the video. No, that's not it. That's a day at Excelsior. I don't know why I have so many things Excelsior in my email. Anybody else? Have you guys been meeting with the artists and everything is okay? I know I saw this thing the other day. Okay. Everything is okay with the artists? No, I saw it in the ice. I don't remember why I was doing an ice sign. I was like, this is actually very good. No, it's not here. Okay, it's not here. I think it's Facebook. It's probably Facebook. All right. So all right, evening, guys, for persons who are here. So as I said before, just updating persons who are not here. We have identified a space for the event. Is actually on it's downtown. The studio's at a church, one of those, you know, those Anglican churches that were in Jamaica from like in the 1669, or one of those very old kind of church. But the studio's at the back. It's very, very acoustic. The area is okay. The area itself is okay. It's not within the range of what is going on downtown. And I just showed persons relate how the quality of work. I think many persons were here before. And we're aiming for August 13 for the actual practical, the live event itself. and everybody will not be required to be at the actual event. You just need to ensure that your artist is actually at the event. Probably the only the group leaders on the day itself would be required to go, because the space itself cannot hold everybody. It's a kind of a studio kind of thing when you want to, you know, do very good music or do a production. The other thing, and this is something that you guys will determine, whether you're going to do pre-recorded or you're going to do it live. Also to whether you want your artist to have a small band or if it is that the artist is going to use tracks. And of course, if there's a small band, then of course there's going to be, you have to do rehearsal and you have to do sound check and things like that. The cost so far, well, the ultimate cost will be about 70,000. But of course, the cost is going to be spread across the class for everybody. I'm going to put some money towards it myself. But what I ask you to do, don't say, oh, sir, he's asking me to take my little salary and go do this. Just create a sponsorship form, which is what the students have done in the past, and just ask for donations. And I have, and on my list, I see 30. If I remember I think I'm seeing in my class, I'm seeing 31 students. So if you divide, let's say 31, because when you create the form, you can know 31.
2.258. It's about a $3,000 per person.
Right, it's about, right. So you can just, you know, create a sponsorship form, get the donation. And Matt, trust me, it's way more than this, but Matthew's, because of her, I mean, we are like, you know, brothers and stuff. We have been friends for a very long time, almost a decade, if not over a decade. So I can call upon him, he can call upon me for favors. Yeah, and we love music. I used to sing, and he plays guitar, he plays the piano, he plays the keyboard, he does a lot of things. He's a really very experienced musician, and he's also an entrepreneur, of course. You know, yeah, he has a family to feed as well. So if everybody can just create a sponsorship form and just get some donations, that would be good. Is that okay with everybody? Does it sound workable, feasible? Is that okay?
Yes, sir, that's okay.
Okay. Yeah, and what I will do, I'll just choose one male and one female in the class to just correspond with Matthew. Of course, Matthew would not want everybody in the class to be calling him. Just one or two persons just to say, okay, Matthew, and Tony, and I want you to be one of the persons to keep in touch, to just make contact with Matthew. So, okay, Matthew, hi, Matthew. I am Tony and from Mr. Clark's class. Or if you want to say Robin, no problem. I'm from Robin's class. And, you know, he had mentioned that we are going to host the event on August 13. He was, you know, can we meet? Can we have a conversation over the phone? When can I come and look at the space? Or is it that each other group leaders can come and look at the space? And, you know, just have a simple conversation. And Matty is very professional. He's a very, very professional person. Very, when it comes down to his music, and he's more Christian than not. So, you know, he's not into, you know, the kind of graphic language, and he's not that type of person. All right. And this is, as I said before, this is why I chose the artists themselves. And this is why I call upon some of my very good friends who respect me and I respect them. And they would not, you know, do certain things that I would consider unethical. All right. All right. So it sounds feasible, guys. Yes.
Sir, yes. Good evening. Yeah, I kind of missed out. I wasn't here the last class.
Mm-hmm.
And I just joined. So Matthew.
So Matthew is a person who is the general manager for the venue that we're going to use for the practical event itself, for the live, the musical event.
Okay.
So he's a person who he's the one that controls the space. And okay. Let me just share screen. And I'm not sure if you saw when I shared screen, I always like to make sure that certain things are not open. I've seen with lecturers, the share screen, and then people saw all kind of stuff. Okay, so this is a space. This is just examples of the space. You'd have to create something like this. This is a space. This is an artist. You know, this is a space. This is a space again. So if you're going to do it in a band, that's a band. Of course, you guys know what is a band, but the band would be smaller because it would be a three-piece band. Or if you're going to, the artist is going to use track. You know, these are just, and the name, this is a promo. And this is a promo. This is a promo. Something like this would also, and we're going to go through the rubric. This is something that you could create for the artists. Again, this is a space, just showing you the space itself. And the name of the, here's the name of the space, PHE Studios. Right, so I mentioned August 13 would be the event. You can decide, you guys have to determine whether you're going to use track or if you're going to use a small band. We said that the cost is roughly 70,000 and that we're going to spread it across the class and that we would seek sponsorship. I'm not asking anybody, especially in this difficult financial time, to take the little money that you're earning to pay for, to contribute. I'm going to actually contribute myself, but just create a sponsorship form, which is what my students have done in the past, and just get some sponsorship. It is a, each student, if you can get a sponsorship of $3,000, it would cover the cost for the venue, all right? And as I said before, Matthew is really doing, as he and I, we were literally working out, you know, the cheapest way to do this thing. And I want you guys to really, you know, get a good feel of how public relations work, the kind of decisions that are being made. And, you know, sometimes, you know, sometimes things don't go your way. Sometimes they do, that kind of thing. It's very, very hands-on. And this is something that I've done in the past. I think this is my, it would be my fourth time doing something like this, teaching at Excelsior. And I'm a lecturer who I'm very, I believe in students being hands-on, not just writing papers, but actually doing things. All right. Any, are you up to speed now, Debbie, or you have questions, still have questions?
Yes, sir. I'm good. Thank you.
Okay, no problems. All right. The other thing I want to show you now is the fact that I have on Canvas, when you go on Canvas, you can see coursework and practical exam. It is there. So when you go on the modules, what I'll do, I didn't realize that these things, the shells are open. And to be honest, this is the responsibility of the college. I'm not supposed to put up content. They're supposed to load it and I just add additional content. But I'm going to put more content. Just give me until tomorrow. I'll put some additional information because really they shouldn't be, you know, this is really not what I'm supposed to be doing. Yeah. And just keep reaching out to the RITs, have conversations with them, do as much as you can in terms of executing. So let's go now to the actual assessment document. So it is divided into coursework and practical exam. Okay, so coursework, practical exam. Coursework, practical exam. So the interview, so what they have on the original course outline here, they have verbal presentation. So verbal presentation has been, is no interview, right? The other thing is, and I'm wondering for mid-semester, probably what I'll do for the mid-semester is actually not give you an actual exam, but give you a piece to do. Either you do the press release or you do a feature story and that becomes the mid-semester exam. Instead of you coming to sit and answer some questions, and because if you can answer questions about public relations, but you can't write a press release, you haven't learned anything, to be honest. So I'm thinking of changing the mid-semester not being an actual, because you realize they don't even have it there. They don't actually have a mid-semester. So, you know, the press release probably can function as the mid-semester. And what I'll do, I'll just make you upload it to turn it in. But it would be individual. It would not be a group. The press release would not be group. It would be individual, an individual press release. And you upload it to turn it in. All right, going back to the assessment document. So let's take this off. It's going to be, let's take that off. You know, exams don't necessarily have to be, you know, sitting in a room kind of thing. The press kit now, and the press kit surrounds the event. So in a press kit, for the press kit, and I'm going to speak about it in more detail, it's usually related to, like, the, in your case, the event. So when people come to the, let us say that you invite the press and they come, right? What would you give them? So you give them a folder, or a kind of a folder that has information in it about your specific artist, you know, feature story about the artist, the musical biography of the artist, branding collaterals, you know, how the artist look in terms of, you know, their image, quote unquote, media advisory about the event itself. And the media advisory is very easy. It's the who, when, what, where, and why of the event. and a promotional flyer as we just as I just showed you. Then now for the practical exam, this is how it is broken down. For the practical exam now, you have the actual music event, musical event. Then you have the PR plan, which some of you have already started working on. Let me take this off. And then you have the promotions, which is all the things that, you know, in terms of social media, creating the flyer, getting them on TV, or, you know, all of those different things, creating the viral moment, all of that becomes a part of promotion. All right, so, and this is just the rubric, the quote unquote, the table of content for the PR plan. And as I said before, we kind of did some of this last week. So this is the PR plan. All right, any questions? The group Venn diagram now, this group contribution, the Venn diagram is just for you to indicate to me the contribution of the contribution of each person in the group using percentage as your metric. So I can see what, you know, let us say that five of us are in the group or seven of us are in the group. Is it that all of us contributed equally, or is it that some persons kind of slag off, you know, they were really laggers in the group. They really didn't do any work. All right. Any questions relating to the assessment? Is it clear now, or, you know, you have any additional questions and all of that?
Sir, it's more clear for me.
Yes. So the mid-semester is going to be the press release. I'm not going to give you an actual exam to sit in any room to do. You're going to actually write a press release, and that is going to be either do the press release or the feature story. I'll give you the option to choose feature story or press release. So in the mid-semester will not be any true and false, or choosing A, B, or C, or I don't believe in those, some of those kinds of exams. I think they're just ridiculous. All right, so this document is on Canvas. The edits that I've done, I'll just re-upload that. All right, so let's get into the lecture today now. So we have kind of talked a little bit about all of that. So let me...
For 1 minute, yes, sir.
Yes, go ahead.
Yes, sir. You had addressed that which I had mentioned just now, earlier on.
Mm-hmm. Which is what?
The group. Regarding
all right, so we'll work it out, but just let me get through the lecture and I'll spend about the last 15 minutes or so going back to the whole group dynamics, okay? Okay?
Okay, sir.
All right, cool. Where is, I had it here. Do I do that one first, or let me do this one? Okay. So I'm going to share a screen so that you guys can appear, and I'm going to upload this. Really, I shouldn't. This is not the property of Excelsior. All right, so press release. Anybody knows anything about press release? Does anybody know anything about press release? Or what do you know about press release? And there is silence. So we don't know anything about press release? Okay. So a press release, it has different
names. It's information that you want to supply to the public, sir.
All right, information. Yeah. But can I not supply information to the public without using a press release?
No, sir, it can be used like, All right, but I'm going to see, sir, I'm going to want, all right, I'm going to say it in my own words, don't quote me, but it's like an official statement, like an announcement to upcoming events or whatever it is you're planning to basically tell the press, it's not good to use but the same word, or the public, sir, of like something meaningful that they should consider. So like an artist, if he's going to release like his album, they would put that out in the press, like create a press release about like a little information about the album. It's like a teaser. That's how I look at it, in a sir. Like a little teaser, like, you know, get
the okay music. So well, in the context of music, it could be seen as a kind of a teaser, but you are very correct that the kind of it's really an official announcement on behalf of, like, by a company, or it could be by an individual or so forth. I'm seeing some responses in the chat. That's okay, Tatiana. So even I'm sure you saw today, and let me see. I'm sure. Did you see the release by? Let me stop sharing screen because I don't want to know if you guys see anything that you're not supposed to see on my social media. But the Jamaica Constabulary Force and the whole popcorn situation about So let me see if I see the actual quote. There was a release, and I'm sure you see that the Jamaica Constabulary Force is actually doing a lot of press releases. They're informing the public about many things, their operations. So if you go on their page, and you should be following them, you will see a lot of releases, and it is part of their PR strategy. In other words, we are doing work. We are not perfect, but we are actually doing work. So there was a release relating to popcorn, but I'm not seeing it here. I actually read it earlier. Sometimes you have to kind of search for it, fight to find it, but not seeing it here. But they actually said that in relation to what the kind of back and forth with popcorn and the government of Jamaica and his detainment in the UK, they actually released something to say that we are not responsible, and that it was Interpol that it was Interpol that actually flagged, that put something on your constabulary force. Let me see. That put something on your file. I don't know why I'm not. I know I read it on Instagram today, because I have to, when you don't live in Jamaica, you're actually very obsessed with information about what's happening in Jamaica. So you are very correct in terms of it being an announcement and so forth. I'm seeing some additional things in the chat. Yes. You saw it on Twitter? It's probably on Twitter. Let me see if it's Twitter then. It probably could have been Twitter. Are we guys on Twitter? I'm not really the biggest fan of Twitter.
His attorney had posted something on Twitter.
Yes, and later had to apologize as well.
Yeah.
And this notion that they're going to sue the government, one thing I know, I'm not an attorney, but I know that you can't sue for a statement of fact. That much I know. You can't, if it's a statement of fact, you cannot sue. So when, for example, if it said that he was arrested or caught with cocaine, if that is actually what was put on his file by the Barbadian government, then of course, or by the Bayesian government, then of course there's no room for him winning the case. All right, I think it's just that it's their version of PR in trying to make people not think that popcorn was taking cocaine. You know, yes, him smoke weed, but he's not a cokehead, or you know, that's how we would characterize it when somebody
takes cocaine. That's why they always said, based on how you use your press release, it can be like a tool, like a manipulative tool, sir, because like even hearing that, I wasn't aware of the situation, to be honest. I know hearing it, and then you said they're going to sue the government. It's like, oh, so why them a blaspheme the man and a create like them that do something wrong? So no, I'm no turn no on him side and all kind of. So it's like based on how they use it, sometimes even how they like puns, like they tend to use a lot of puns, play on words in the press release to kind of like bring about whatever they want you to feel about a situation. So you have persons who are using this thing really, really well. And
One thing I'll say though, that when you're if you're a professional, press release cannot have any pun or any sarcasm or anything like that. If it has that in it, most times the press houses will ignore it. So that's one thing that you will actually learn in this in my class, that your press release should not have any pun. It's very, very simple and direct language. So let's go back to the press release itself has several names. So sometimes it's called a news release. It's also called a media release, press statement, or in the case, sometimes it's a video release. And I think I've mentioned to you that some companies or some media houses know, if you send them only a written press release, then you might get ignored. They want to hear, they want the press release to also have an audio so that they can hear if it's a direct quote, for example, from the principal or from the attorney. They want to hear that. And let's look at let me show you exactly what I'm talking about, because on Nationwide, not the one that says it's on your side, not that one. And there was actually, they were quoting the latest news. Is that the latest? That's not the latest. Right, here it is. And you, did I turn on my sound? I'm sure I turned on my sound. And you're, where's the, is it not embedded? They usually, or it's only on the, yeah, but where's the audio? They usually have the audio. Okay, I don't see the audio here, but it usually has, let me see if it is here. Yes, so this is an example. Like when you're sending a press release, so you have the words, but you also, many times, especially as a radio station, they want to actually hear something, so like a direct quote from whoever you think is important. So let's listen.
This is why it's important that when conflicts are...
Are you here? Did you hear that?
No, sir.
No, you didn't hear it. That means, am I sharing sound?
Sir, I'm just... hearing it. I heard it through.
Oh, okay, as I'm saying, I'm sharing sound. So what happened?
Observed within communities, the police are notified that we can intervene before it becomes a crime. And so this is one area that although we are extending ourselves into it, there are other partners that have to be a part of that change in communities where it's...
So the Jamaica Constabulary Force now is sending a press release to nationwide or sending a press release to the media houses. They would have to... if they don't want to be ignored in many instances, they would want to have an audio of the actual police commissioner. So the nature of press releases have somewhat evolved, and you're going to find that there are some other things that I'm going to talk a little bit about in terms of press releases. Searches, for example, in terms of keywords, because you want the press release to be able to kind of be responsive on Google search engine. So you use certain keywords, whether they are short keywords or long short tail keywords or long tail keywords, and how that now is important in terms of even search engine optimization, so that when people are Googling, they can find the artist. And if you're putting your press release on, for example, social media, you use, for example, hashtags, because hashtags make your releases visible. In the event that somebody is searching for something on Twitter, if they're typing the hashtag, then the actual press release will come up. So the nature of press releases have been woven into the gamut of new media. So a press release is a written or recorded communication directed at members of the news media for the purpose of announcing something ostensibly newsworthy. You'll find too that sometimes the press release is not necessarily directed at the media houses, but it could be directed at fans, because social media have changed how how the media landscape operates. We now have what I call community journalists. Today, somebody referred to some persons on Twitter as, you know, you have social media lawyers. They are not actual, attorneys, but they operate as such because they are judge, jury, and prosecution on social media, and they do everything. So sometimes, like for example, a Spice does not, as an artist, does not need TVG or CVM or any media host to announce anything about her. Let's just say that she has a new song coming out, or she has done some sort of partnership, or she's going to be in a movie. She can use her social media handle to do a press release. All right. So the nature of how even press releases are sent or are published no longer has to include and involve media houses. So release, typically they are faxed or emailed to assigned editors and journalists at newspapers, magazines, radio stations, television stations, or television news networks. What that means, and I deliberately want to show you, is the fact that sometimes when your release does not get published, it's because you send it to the wrong editor. Let's look at what I'm talking about. So Jamaica Gleaner. Let me see if I find something. So this is the Jamaica Gleaner, right? Everybody see my screen?
Yes, sir.
Right. So if you look here, these are what? Different categories, right? Are these different categories?
Yes, sir. To each
right.
one.
Right. Mm-hmm. So if it is that your news release is about sports, you need to find who is the editor for the sports section of the media house and send it directly to that person. If, for example, you send your media release to just a generic Gleaner email, it might not get published because the person who's supposed to get it does not get it. And remember too, that you're not the only person, or you're not the only company or the only brand who's sending out media releases. They're getting tons of media releases every day, and they have to make a decision which ones they're going to publish. So you want to ensure that you send it to the right person or to the right editor. That's very, very key. All right. In my role, when I worked as a public relations officer, and I had to do press releases, one of the things that I used to ask my admin support to do is to call the media house and find out who is the chief editor for education, for matters relating to education, so that I could send it directly to that person. So, and then I also had a list of media houses contacts, and you constantly have to be updating the list. Sometimes you have to sit down. I used to make the admin support do that. Call all of them and ask, who is the chief editor? Who is the contact person here? Have you changed this person? Because people who work in media, they're always changing. It's like a revolving door. They go into other lucrative opportunities. All right, so that's something you have to be very mindful about. A great release provides critical information, gets published, and could be carried verbatim. So when it says could be carried verbatim, meaning that when you send the media release, they might just publish it as is, if they consider it to be newsworthy. Let me show you an example now where, so usually you don't pay for your press release to be published, but as a PR officer, I realized something that, let me stop sharing screen. So let me find the example, because I'm going to go on Facebook. I don't know, I have some very strange friends and I don't know what they're putting on social media. So let me find it first. All right, so let's go to Excelsior. yes, my friends are very crazy. So I usually have to close things and open. All right, so let me show you an example. Are you seeing my screen?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Seeing it.
All right, so let me show you something, right? So we see that this is actually a Gleaner article, right? It was published by the Gleaner. Over 500 Excelsior students benefit from overseas opportunities. So that we click on it, the article will come up. This page doesn't work. That's not true. Here it is. So we see this is an actual article, right? That speaks to the international opportunities at Excelsior. When we look at as a public relations officer now, the other thing that you need to do, so this is a media release. The other thing that you need to do on your end is to look at what are called analytics, social media analytics. So we see, for example, that it has reached what? 346 persons, right? 28 engagements. Are you seeing all of that, people?
Yes, sir.
Okay. As a PR officer, let me see if you're thinking, what else could you do to this? What else could you do with this press release that is published on social media by the institution in order to reach other people?
Sir, maybe pay for paid advertisement.
Exactly. You could boost it. You could boost it, right? Because if you look at it, right, only 346 persons were reached. And if you click on the 346 persons and you look at the back end, you're going to go to the back end now. Like, six comments, 22 post clicks, view details. Let's go into view. They're supposed to give us some more information. Are they giving us information? Let's hope they are. All right, so they should be giving us some information. I'm not seeing the information that I would want, actually. But let me tell you what I would have done. The other thing that I would do as a PR officer. So one, remember we talked about publics, right? Or we talked about target audience. Remember we talked about it, demographic, psychographic, and all of that. Does everybody remember that?
Yes, sir.
Right. Romario, they don't have to send it to the media houses. They can, but they don't have to. So one thing I used to, this is why I say that PR officers also need to have marketing background. So one, you need to determine now who form part of your publics, right? And also two, if you post this on social media, what are you trying to achieve as a public relations officer? right? What are you trying to achieve? So am I posting this just for posting it's sake? Notice that this does not have a copy. They just have the link. So this is actually poorly published. This is actually not done, not published properly, because even see the Gleaner link. This is actually not your, what, how you're supposed to do it. You're supposed to, I can actually edit. So you edit it. You edit it. Look at the line. Choose a line. You might say something like, let me see if my cursor can. Enter Excelsior Community College provides international, or not provides, but creates international opportunities for its students. Several have received scholarships, internships, and what's the other term? Scholarships. Have received scholarships, internships, and study abroad, and have participated
cultural exchange
in study. No, I don't want to say in study abroad. Study abroad, abroad programs. In, you might say, Canada and the USA. Where are the hashtags? Hashtag Excelsior Community College. See what I'm saying? Hashtag ECC Life, because that's one of them. Hashtag, next one, study abroad. Hashtag, study in Canada. See it here? 1 million. Hashtag. This is what I mean? So you don't just post your press release on social media without, exactly, scholarship, because students like to what? Search for scholarships. I'm not going to post this, though. No, I'm not going to interfere. I'm no longer the boss, so I'm not going to do any of that. So you don't just post it for posting's sake. You actually have to have what? A PR strategy in place. And this is why the PR plan is important. So you develop a strategy. This would be a part of your PR strategy to get, for example, 5 press releases. One of the, you might say one press release might focus on the international opportunities offered by ECC. One of our media release might be a feature story on one of our students who has received a 4.0 GPA. Another one might be on an alumni who has opened his or her own business. Another one might be on one of our graduate study students was being promoted to, like, for example, a senior manager. So you actually sit down and you properly plan it. You don't just do things in a very scattered way, so that you can actually sit down and measure now to say, okay, what are the successes or the success of my public relations plan, and where does a press release fit in all of that? Make sense, guys?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Another thing too, when you're going to sponsor this, so let us say that we're going to boost this ad, right? And I'm going to show you, we're going to boost the ad. So you want to know, what is the call to action? Book now, learn more. In this case, I would want them to learn more. The website is there. Do they direct people traffic to your website, or do you want them to? So I wouldn't direct them to the website unless there is something on the website that actually speaks to what the article is about. That's another thing too, as a public relation officer, you have to ensure that all the touch points are properly what? Coordinated. Make sense? So I wouldn't send them to the website, because if we go onto ECC website, this is what we're seeing. Do we see anything about international opportunities? No, we don't. We don't see it. Unless they created a landing page that was specific to this, right? So I wouldn't send them to the website. I would actually say message, right? Another thing is audience. This is important. So I'm not sure what is happening there. So the audience that we target at ECC, the demographic that we target at ECC, or the regions we're targeting at ECC, the geographic location is Kingston, St. Thomas, St. Catherine, and Portland. Is it Portland? So Kingston, St. Thomas, St. Catherine. What's the other one? It's four of them. Can't remember the other one. Then another thing we do in as a part of our audience, we target working professionals, so people like yourself, working professionals, parents, concerned parents, and high school graduates. And that you can be able to do here. You can actually type it in. So here's St. Thomas. And even when we say St. Catherine, we still put in like Portmore, then you can target based on interests. So what interests? Persons who are interested in doing an associate degree, an academic degree, persons who are interested in like business and finance, business school. So there are several things, there are several other things you would have to do in order, in relation to your press release. So you're writing it. Yes, you send it off to the media houses. Yes, the media houses publish it, but it doesn't mean that it hits home with the actual demographic that you're trying to target. Make sense? So you have to know, go to social media now, because there are certain tools that are there that can help you to further achieve whatever the institutional goal is. Yes, I want to confirm that they're closing it. They think I want to spend money. I don't have any money to give you. So all of this now has to be a part, a part of a public relations campaign. It's not something that you can just, you know, you just create, write a press release and you're just sending it to media houses. I actually had to explain to my former boss, Mr. McCarthy, that this notion that you want the article to be published by the Gleaner. At the end of the day, yes, it is published by the Gleaner and it brings some amount of legitimacy, but who's seeing it when it goes into the Gleaner? The Gleaner, on the Gleaner's social media handles, they are only putting up stuff that is what? Controversial. So stuff relating to popcorn, stuff relating to corruption and the government, stuff relating to violence in the society. So they're not going to put up an article that focuses primarily on what? Excelsior. Because that is not going to drive the clicks and the comments and all of the traffic to their website so that they can get additional advertisers. So it's a very big ecosystem that the PR officer is operating in, and when the PR officer creates a press release. I hope I'm making sense. Making sense, guys? We are silent.
Yes, sir, I understand.
Okay. Any questions, comments, any concerns? All right. Why is it not changing? Oh. Why I want to do this? Yeah. Did I go back to the right thing? Yeah, we did that. Yes. So make the difference. So what's the story, the hook, the angle? How can this cut through the clutter? Why in the world would anyone care about what you have written? So it's important that your press release is newsworthy. Is it newsworthy? If you write a release and you send it to a media host, or even if you post it on social media, you don't necessarily have to rely on media houses anymore. Why would anyone read it? You know, what's so special about it? Why would we want to read it? You know, is it interesting? Does it make sense? Or, you know, why would anybody read it? So when you're going to write a release, you need to find a way to make it newsworthy. So sometimes even on social media, I see people comment on like, why the Gleaner's writing about popcorn? Or why the Gleaner's writing about macadamia? Or why the Gleaner's writing about this? And people don't understand that there are different categories or types of news. There's something called entertainment news. That's why we have E-Prime. That's why we have Entertainment Report. That's why we have all of these. We have MTV, and they have their own reporters. CNN has entertainment reporters when it comes on to things like the Oscars and all of that. So what can you, when you talk to the artists, and you get a little sense, you get a sense of who they are, or you look at their catalog, or you listen to their catalog, and what in their private life, or what can they say to you that would become newsworthy? For example, Dougie has been interviewed on national TV. I think it was either CVM or TVJ. He has actually been interviewed on national television, because at the time they found something that they considered to be newsworthy. So it's for you now to sit down and really, as the PR person, investigate and find out What makes something newsworthy? I think I have, and I have an example. You know, of course, I'm going to close. I think there was something that I did for Excelsior, and I actually never sent it to any media house, and it was, but would I find it now? I don't think I'm going to find it. It was about, can I search School of Performing Arts? Let me see if I find it. School of Performing Arts. Let me see. Trying to find it on. All right, so School of Performing Arts. I wrote this release for them. I sent it to the media houses. They never published it. But what was important about this is the fact that they finally got their program accredited. Finally got their program accredited. And of course, you know, the School of Performing Arts is a much smaller, they would attract a smaller demographic because they don't have everybody running to become performers, quote unquote, or getting formal training in performance. Many times you find that the persons who are interested in performing arts, they actually end up doing tourism, because they feel that tourism is a brighter way of becoming an entertainer or participating in the entertainment industry. So you find that a smaller demographic reached 109 people, 6 comments, 10 shares. So it's a smaller demographic. I think I've written other pieces for Excelsior. Can't remember all of them. This was actually published, and I don't have to get into all my pieces that were published. So it's important for you to identify the angle. What can I talk about in this release that a media house would consider to be newsworthy? Or if I'm going to put it on social media, what would generate discussion? And remember now, the press release should not have sarcasm and puns and be sensational. If it has those things, then it's not a release. It's an editorial. So you have to find a way now to make the story, find the story or the hook based on what, based on consultation with the artist. The other thing too, when it says being able to cut through the clutter, the title of the release, what would make a entertainment editor, for example, let's just say at the Gleaner, going through thousands or if not hundreds of press releases, stop and say, you know, I'm going to publish this. And it looks at the headline, because most times it's the headline that catches their eye. You know, if the headline doesn't catch them, they say, okay, oh Lord, I have no interest. What can you write that would generate some amount of interest in the eyes of the editor? So make the difference. A press release must be newsworthy. You have to find that angle that can create interest. Very, very, very important. What is news? So if a dog bites a man, that's not news. But if a man bites a dog, that is news. Does anybody want, can you see why the latter would be considered news and the former would not be considered news?
Man biting a dog is not the norm.
It's not the norm. So in other words, news itself is controversial. News itself is controversial. I remember when I was doing a PR course at UA, and I think if I remember correctly, one of my professors said that news is every and anything that people care about all the time. In the moment. I can't remember. There's a particular saying. I used to have it very good in my head. I can't remember. But news is something that is considered to be controversial or out of the norm or extraordinary. So you're trying to find that extraordinary thing, right? So young entertainer talks about mental health or talks about his mad mother living on the streets of Kingston or something like that. That probably could become something seen as newsworthy, because entertainer, mother being mentally ill, living on the streets, that's not the norm. And this is just a graphic demonstrating the thing about the news, right? So who determines, hey, dad, did you hear the news? No, I haven't seen CNN yet today. What's CNN? So news to some extent is also generational. So you also have to know who you're going after in terms of when you're sending out your press release, anything that you consider to be newsworthy. Who are you trying to reach? Sometimes if, for example, you're an up and coming artist, or if your fan base is young, you send it to the media houses, yes, they might not publish it. You put it out on your social media and hope that, you know, it will generate some amount of interest among your fan base. So news in and of itself sometimes is generational. The interest that some people have in certain news topics is will be varied. So some people, they will not watch news unless they hear that five people get shot downtown. If the news is good, they don't find it interesting. They're like, oh my God, I want to see that, you know. But if they hear that two men did a fight downtown, or three people get shot, or them here say, matey and matey did a fight, and you know, that kind of thing, they're ready to watch, and or they're ready to participate. Even the whole popcorn situation, you have people on social media behave as if they know the facts of the matter. It's the Jamaican government, and I'm saying, how you know it's the Jamaican government? And I say, some of them have never traveled, so they don't know what it is like when you are traveling. You know, I'm saying, because I've traveled, I've been traveling since 2006. I can't number the amount of times I've traveled even since I've come to Canada. I've been to Jamaica, been back to Jamaica about eight times. I've been in Canada from 2019. I've been to Jamaica about eight times, back and forth, back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. And sometimes I just drive across to the US, because the US, New York is just 3 or 4 hours away from where I live. So news in and of itself sometimes is very generational. And as a result, it becomes, the interests are different. So young people, news for them is entertainment or something that they consider to be controversial, or it could be that news for them could be graduation. They want to see, you know, hear about the graduation, as opposed to some persons who are much older. News for them is watching something about medication, or listening to the news about COVID, or about monkeypox. Or news could be something that is actually shared across the board, where all groups of people have a general interest. For example, COVID-19, especially when it just came onto the scene, everybody was paying attention. Once you could actually, you know, you have critical thinking skills, you were paying attention. So whether you're young, or whether you're old, or whether you were in between middle age, everybody was paying attention. So you have these various groupings. You have these various demographics who determine what news is for them. It's not the same. The same definition is not across the board for everyone. I, for example, I love watching international news. So even when I was in Jamaica, I watch a lot of CNN, MSNBC, Fox News. I'm just into international news, partly because my first degree is in international relations and literature is in English. So I love foreign affairs, love to listen to the news about foreign affairs. That's just a general interest of mine. When I'm watching Jamaican news, when I'm in Jamaica, I actually don't watch the news. I usually just read on social media, and I try to go to respected sources like the Gleaner or the Observer, not even the Star. Gleaner or the Observer, if they publish it, then I tend to believe, or Nationwide, the respected media houses. I'll actually read those things, and I have a general interest in terms of what's happening in the country. Any questions? Make sense? And here we have some examples of things that might be considered newsworthy. All right. Anybody wants to hazard a guess as to why any of this would be considered newsworthy?
Sir, I think because it's different, you're not really seeing regular persons doing that.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Somebody else was saying something? Go ahead. Give me one sec. Matthew is calling you back. One sec. Yes, so these are things that are considered news. And I'm sure you have, even in the instance where they said that when Usain Bolt was traveling and he was caught, well, he was photographed with these different females, you know, people created all kinds of news stories out of it. So anything that is considered controversial is considered news. Why is this thing, does it take this long to, oh, it needs me to do this. So how do you write a good press release? So it has various, there are various, let's call it, there's a checklist that you use for creating, for writing a press release, and we're going to get into that. Sorry. So a press release is like a conversation between two professionals. Even if it is lighthearted, it cannot be funny. It has to be professional. So you must eliminate goofy texts and do not use silly gimmicks. So if you want to be considered a professional and be treated as such, then you have to be professional in writing, in constructing your press release. A press release must not be promotional. So it is not an ad. And many companies make that mistake of sending a press release that is really a commercial or really an ad. And many times the media houses, they don't publish this because the assumption on the side of the media house is that you're trying to use our press for free advertising. In other words, this is really an advertisement that you claim is a press release. So you try to ensure that it is not promotional in that sense, all right, by using certain particular language. And we're going to get into in terms of transitive verbs versus intransitive verb, active voice versus passive voice when you're writing a press release. Another thing, be enthusiastic and informative. I would say more informative than enthusiastic. A good writer is one who can make even the driest subject informative and entertaining for the readers. You're communicating with the journalists. Boring content will be rejected. And sometimes it's not just boring content. It's just that you don't understand the brand or the brand voice. And as a result, you don't know how to convey that in the spirit of your press release. So that is something that you have to be very mindful about. All right, so there was an issue with, let me stop sharing screen. So we're going to continue this. I need to look at my participants list. Right. Okay. So I know some persons may have dropped the course. Have no issues with that. If persons have dropped the course, that's not an issue. I just hope that they realize that after a certain week in the semester, you can't drop a course. I hope they know that. And sometimes they don't find that out until at the end of the semester. Many times they don't find that out until at the end of the semester. So I hope persons are, you are very much afraid with the regulations surrounding adding or dropping courses, all right? I can't stop anybody from dropping any course, from dropping my course. However, the issue concerning group work, again, I don't know, we're still having the discussion about group work. I thought it was settled. I know that about a few persons emailed me to say that they are going to do another course. I said, kudos. However, it created a gap in terms of the dynamics, in terms of the group numbers. Oski, I think the group that was dealing with Oski, that was a group that emailed me to say that they are no longer doing the course. However, I'm almost sure that I'm seeing some of those persons still in the course. So I just want to find out what is happening. The group members that were working with Oski, have you guys been meeting with Oski? What's happening? The other groups are fine because I've been communicating with the other groups and they've been providing me with some amount of update. And before we go, Tony, just remember to just send me a direct message after the class so I can give you the contact details for Matthew. Okay?
Okay, sir.
Yes. So I'll let you and Romario be the liaisons for the class, okay? So Romario, you as well, okay? I think more Romario can actually talk, but I'll just make you and just work with Matthew and you can work on the logistics and all of that. It makes better sense to just have two persons instead of the entire class sending him information because I don't want him to say, Robin, I'm not going to do this thing because it's too much. All right, so Donovan, which group are you in? And which artists are you working with?
The Voice, sir.
Oh, you're working with The Voice. Okay, okay. Have you guys been meeting with him?
We actually did a greeting today.
Oh, very nice. How was that?
But he preferred to like to speak with two members. So what it did was just to greet hello. Mm-hmm. And then I think Diane and Roberta continued the conversation.
Mm-hmm. Okay, okay. How was that, Diane?
Diane?
Oh, yeah, she said it was awesome.
It was
yeah, she said it was. I know The Voice.
Yes, sir,
the voice
only three of us will be in direct contact with him.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yeah, only three of us. I will be managing his social media. So we already set up what will be happening. So I need to actually get his contact right now because I wasn't able to stay on to the meeting long because they pushed back the meeting and then wanted for somebody else to put it. No, it was not bad.
Yeah, that's okay.
I got to see his face and all his introduction. His spirit is like a free, kind of calm, easy to talk to kind of speak. And also, I know that.
Yeah, it is. He's very professional, very, very professional guy and very talented as well. Very, very talented. So good to hear that. Is there any group that has six persons? Any group that has six persons? No? Debbie, Mrs. Brooks Campbell, which artist your group is working with again?
Mr. Dougie Jericho.
How is that going?
Sir, remember you were supposed to get back to me.
No, I thought it had improved because I reached out to a few persons to get in touch because he didn't take my call because he knew I'm calling to cuss him, but I realized it didn't answer me.
All right, let me update you tomorrow.
Okay,
I'll send you a message.
Okay, so if things don't change, then we can change the artist then.
All right, sure.
Yeah, cool. No probs. How many persons are in your group, Debbie?
Sir, I think it's five or six. Let me double check.
Yeah, double check and let me know.
Yeah, give me a sec. I'm gonna check.
Okay. If anything, I'll just ask you to add Ruth to your group. Okay.
No, sir. We're full. Seven.
Oh, you actually have seven members. Okay.
Yes, sir.
I have the list. All right. So Ruth, just send me a WhatsApp message and I'll do the follow up. Okay. I'm going to resolve it by morning.
Okay, sir.
Okay. All right, guys. Have a very good evening. I enjoyed today's class. Just remember some of the things that we agreed to in terms of the date for the event and some of your own, what's her name? What's her name again? Tony Ann and Sir Clark will message me to give me so that I can give them Matthew's contact details. Continue to meet with the artists. We did say that you have to make a decision whether or not you're going to do live band versus versus the artist using pre-recorded music. We did say that the cost for the production will be $70,000 and that we would spread it across the class. All you need to do is just to create a sponsorship form and get some funds, ask for some sponsorship. I will also contribute to the production. You don't necessarily have to be physically at the location on the day of the event. We said it is August 13 and all of that. Seeing a hand, Kumiko, go ahead.
Sorry, you had said that we're doing a press release for the mid-semester, but
yes, it's about week six, I think, if I remember correctly, either week six or week seven. But I follow the calendar of events that is sent by, that's the same one that is sent to you as students is the same one that I use.
Okay, the instructions will be posted on Canvas as to how to
construct. No, so I'm going to walk you through how to write a press release. So I've started teaching you about it. So I'm going to walk you through actually writing a press release, and then I'm going to show you the rubric that I'm going to use to grade your press release.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. And it will be individual work for everybody, and then you're going to upload it to Turnitin. All right, guys, I don't want to keep you any longer because I'm almost sure you have another class. So have a very good evening. If you have any burning questions, you can send me an email or just send me a WhatsApp message and I can respond accordingly. Okay.
All right. So good night.
All right. Have a good night, everybody.
Okay, sir.
Shanice, your group wants one. Ruth, can you join that group for me? Shanice Greenland's group. Okay, Ruth, did you hear me? She's still here.
Yes, sir, I heard you. Thank you.
Yes, Shani's Greenland. So just reach out to her and join. All right. Bye, guys.